concept of a game is it targets kids between ages of 7 to 9, and kids don't like to learn, like they like to play, but parents always want them to learn. So this game incorporates both the things. It's fun and it helps them learn. So I'll start with the storyline. So basically, the story behind our game is that a boy, he's like on a vacation with his parents, and then he gets lost because they get shipwrecked, and he ends up on an island. And basically, he's trying to find his parents, navigating through the island. On the island are many wizards who will give him spelling challenges, and he has to answer them in order to proceed ahead. And basically, these wizards are guarded by monsters, and the kid has to kill these monsters before he can go ahead. So that's the fun part. In the end, like, our goal is to make the kid reunite with his parents. So, so these are the instructions, and I don't know if you can read it, but
we don't want to read it. Just move on.
So it's like our goals are to find each monster, kill it, and then answer questions for the wizards. And there are objects strewn across the island. They're like extra credit for the child. And on answering those questions, you'll get some coins. So you can use these coins to buy health, power refills, and some other cool stuff. We'll see later on. And these are the basically these instructions, they explain the controls. So that's the joystick, and these are the buttons that are used to kill the monsters. There's the magic box. It contains the health and the power refills, and that's the score, the coin count, and the player health. So you can just skip on the storyline into as you can see, we have a mini map on the top right hand side, and I don't know if it's visible, but there's a red dot that tracks the progress of the player across the island, and we can see our first object there. So when we go near the object, it speaks spell me, and then you can just hear the audio for that.
Cheer.
And then we can just spell it. And as you can see, the coins increased. Okay, and when you go ahead, there are more objects here. To answer them, or you can just skip them because they're like extra credit. So yeah, and then there's our first monster behind the fire. As you can see, as I go near the monster, I can see the health bar for the monster also, and now it will start firing against you, and we use the instant kill bar to kill the monster. So there are three parts. One is the regular fire. Okay. So there are three kinds of fires. One is the regular fire, and the other one is the blue one that you see, that decreases the health of the monster by 50%. And then the one at the top, for all monsters but the last one, it decreases, like it instantly kills the monster. So that's the first spelling challenge. You can see four options. So, and we can get audio for this also. And if I give a correct answer, so it will ask me to continue. Then that's the second challenge. For instance, if I answer wrong, it will ask me to input the answer in the text box. So then if I give the correct answer, will ask me to continue. But if I input the wrong answer in the text box, then it will keep on telling me the correct answer again and again until I input the right answer. So this is the spirit behind the game, that the child should learn no matter what. So he can't skip ahead and just, you know, leave it to just play the game. He'll have to learn the spelling part as well. That there are more objects that we can use for extra credit.
Clock.
Okay, so now I'll come to the inventory. So we've got a health refill. Let's just go to the next one. As you can see, that's the second monster, and when we go near it, it will start looking at the player and then start firing at the player. Otherwise, he's just dancing around. So we've got a health refill. We can refill the cards, refill the fire. So buy, and it increases the firepower by 20. So as you can see, the coins have decreased, and the power, when we go back, the power has increased again. So moving ahead, I'll just skip through the island for the sake of the demo. We've made this button that takes us to the final combat. So the island is full of monsters like these, and the final one is much more difficult than the regular ones. So now I'm at the end of the island, and this one is much more difficult to kill. I mean, the monsters get difficult progressively. So this one decreases the player health by a considerable amount, as you can see, 30. And now you can buy some health. So as you can see, the health got refilled. And I'll try to, try to kill the monster. This is very difficult. As you can see, our own powers have got very little effect on this one. So, the thing behind this is, you should have answered all the extra credit questions in order to have earned enough points so that you can buy enough health and enough powers in order to kill this last monster. And as you can see, he lost, and yeah. So there's had he won, there's a similar win sequence for this monster.
All right, great.
So that's it.
Thank you.